Hey guys, it's Neo again. This video is going to be on traction by hand, which in my case nearly completely cured my Peyronies. And when I say cure, I mean I barely have any visible scarring or indentation anymore. I used to have quite a bit, and for me, traction completely smoothed out the curve, removed the hourglass deformity and the kind of indentations. And the results were very dramatic for me over the years. And also just after even just one session, I get a kind of, how can I say this? The symptoms are reduced for a while right after I do it. And it's been like this for me since the start. And I've noticed that small improvements over time turn into permanent improvements. So if I do traction once by hand right now, afterwards, my symptoms are reduced a little bit, but if I keep doing that for days and days and months and years, those results turn to permanent results. So it's a lot like the opposite of getting Peyronie's, where micro damage over years builds up and then becomes permanent damage, permanent deformity. So with traction, you want to do it as much as possible, as gentle as possible, but often enough to where those positive results are going to turn into permanent results. And let me just say that, yeah, traction is, you know, I consider it the best physical therapy. Some people might think vacuum devices is better. It just kind of depends. But I think traction is the single best treatment for Peyronie's besides the metabolic aspect. So besides the diet, and if there is a metabolic origin to the disease, I think the number one treatment is traction. And why do you have to use a device? You don't have to use a device. You can use your hand. You know, you have to keep in mind that the reason why there's no studies on traction by hand is because there's nobody who profits from that. It's kind of like with diabetes. Fasting has been shown to cure or reverse type 2 diabetes, and even type 1. It can even keep type 1 at bay or partially reverse it, but that wasn't studied until just recently. And how many years has diabetes been around? You know, it's kind of funny. Sometimes the simplest answer to something, or sometimes the best answer is the most simple answer, and it's the one that nobody wants to do and is very hidden from you. So in this case, we're talking about traction by hand. You know, there have been studies on traction devices, and that's again because you can patent these things, and then it's like a treatment, and the doctor can like give you the protocol and all this stuff. But it's unfortunate how this happens in medicine, where you know, the research follows the money. And I'm not criticizing the research. You know, that's all we have. We have to. You know, we love the research. I love reading research, and I, you know, it's great. But there are some problems with the way this stuff works. Another example is pentoxifilin. Pentox, the drug often prescribed for Peyronie's, it's really the same. It's very similar to caffeine. It's a xanthine derivative, and you know, you could take Pentox and pay a lot for that, or you could just drink 4 cups of coffee a day. You know, and you know, now in the same sense as how fasting is being shown to cure diabetes, now drinking coffee and caffeine is shown to reverse and prevent fibrosis of the liver and even other organs. So finally, the research is catching on to the things that people wouldn't really think about, or stuff that's more that's less profitable. You know, maybe there should be a name for this phenomenon in research, but I guess it's pretty self-explanatory or simple to explain. But it's interesting too, because in the Xiaflex manual, there's something in it called modeling. And it tells you after you get Xiaflex treatment for Peyronie's, you need to model your penis. And it's quite rigorous. You stretch your penis both flaccid and you even bend it erect. I don't recommend that. I don't think that's safe. But it's funny, you know, it's like, as long as they get the shots, we can recommend traction by hand, and we'll call it modeling, by the way. You know what I mean? So they try to make it a part of something else, and then you wonder, why didn't they just recommend modeling from the start? Yeah, it's really silly. But yeah, again, it's nobody's fault. It's just nobody can make money off it, you know. I mean, I could, you know, try to sell a protocol and traction by hand protocol and charge people for it. And you know, I think somebody even tried something like that, but whatever. You know, I think everybody should have access to this information for free. Especially something as serious as Peyronie's. So, let me just get into this. I have a lot of guys asking me about traction by hand. And as I said, or as I may have said before, you know, traction by hand completely, almost completely cured my Peyronie's, completely smoothed out my curve, and it helps me so much. To this day, I still do it every day, even for like a couple seconds. People ask me all the time about what my protocol is, and I'm sorry to tell you, I don't have a specific protocol. And I know people like to have a protocol, they like to have a plan, and then they can kind of feel better about it and, you know, feel like they're actually proactively following this protocol. And maybe I could write something up for someone. I absolutely could, but I just don't follow any kind of protocol because I don't I think it's hard. I think it's hard to find time to follow a protocol. And then if you have some kind of protocol, you know, you let's say you fail and you don't do it a certain day, then you feel like a failure and then you stop. It's better just to kind of wing it. And as long as you're being safe, I don't mean just like start stretching at your penis and, you know, hope it just turns out. I mean, yeah, you really should be more adaptable with it. So yeah, I can still tell you though what I do, how I do it, because I do think it's kind of unique. For example, Dr. Levine in Chicago, he recommends traction with a device for like six, at least 6 hours a day. A lot of the studies are on people who use the devices for like 6 hours a day. And that's a long time, and I imagine it is useful because of that duration and the time under tension. But I don't really rely on time under tension. So what do I do? The way I do traction is more it's more dynamic, and the way it helps me is not so much the tension. So I'm very gentle. So instead of using tension and time, I use angle and change of angle. So I focus on the angle of traction by hand, right? And then I change the angle quite quickly. I think it would look pr pretty silly if somebody saw it actually. And I wish I had a way to show you. I can show you kind of how I do it without actually showing you. But I think it's important that you understand kind of the difference here, that I do focus on angle. I focus on changing the angle quite regularly and really just kind of feeling it out. And I know that that's not a definitive or kind of clear answer for you, but in my opinion, traction and focusing on time under tension is not as effective as focusing on the angle. So I have sat for 2 hours straight, stretching my penis straight in one direction out from my body. I have done that many times, and that does not help me as much as changing the angle and doing what I do by hand. I'm sure there is something to be said for time under tension, and I'm sure, and I know the studies conclude that those who use the traction device longer had better results. But for me, there's something different going on, and improving my deformity is achieved through angle and changing the angle. And I also achieve this without doing it that often. So when I first started doing traction by hand, I would watch a movie and do it, you know. And then as I got less time and as my improvements started kicking in, I started doing traction just kind of whenever, especially in the shower. I always do in the shower. I always do it when I take a piss too. Oh man, yeah. Guys, it's funny. Traction Manual traction helped me so much. I remember when I started doing it, the length of my flaccid penis like changed dramatically. I had the whole hard flaccid symptoms and the turtling and all that stuff, and traction by hand just got rid of it and made my penis elastic and longer. And I remember just looking down and being like, wow, like I guess this is how a normal penis is supposed to look. And I just never knew all this time. And it really was a miracle for me. But I'm sure you want to know the specifics on how to do it. So I don't have my phone, so I can't really even show you the like positions that I do it in. But let's just start from the basics. The basics are you use two fingers, just your like an okay sign, and you can do overhand or underhand grip. It doesn't really matter. You can alternate, depends on what hand you're using. I use both hands. I alternate hands to change the angle. This is pretty important. So I'll do the right hand to get a certain angle and then the left hand to get another angle. Let's see. All right, so how do I do this? If you're sitting in a chair and you're just leaning back like this, you take your hand an okay grip like this. So I'm doing an overhand grip, okay sign. And you're going to grab right under the glands gently and pull out from your body with your flaccid penis, never erect. You can be slightly engorged with blood, but I don't recommend it. And you're just going to pull out. Man, I wish I had a better camera so I could show you, but I just can't. There's just no way to do it. Oh, there we go. Oh, hell yeah. Awesome. I can do this. Don't mind the messy room here. Oh, this is perfect. All right. So let's say you're sitting back like this and you're just pulling straight out. So, overhand grip out like this, right? And typically with a traction device, you'd be going straight out, right? Just like straight out like this. And for me, I do much better to go to the side, both sides. So right to the leg, both sides, okay? And for me, it's really a stretch down. So when I first started doing this, I tried to stretch my penis up like this, up towards my body. And my scarring is at the bottom of my penis. So I thought, okay, if it's at the bottom, I want to bend it this way and stretch it up this way. And I used to do that for days, but it just didn't work. If I do it now, it barely changes the deformity. Now, it might help you. So it depends on your case. Okay, I have a lot to say about this, but it does depend on your case, probably, but maybe not. So let me try to explain myself here. Because I have scarring at the bottom of my penis, you would think that pulling it up would help, right? But it's the opposite. For some reason, I have to stretch it down and to the right and to the left. And what really works for me is sitting at the end of a chair and the same grip overhand. And straight down to the ground like that. And then beyond that, it's important to change angles. So you'll see, I'll literally go from behind my leg and grab it. It's crazy. And stretch under my leg with both hands, both sides, and go back and forth. And it looks fucking weird, you know? Maybe that's another reason you don't hear about this, because I must look like a lunatic. But literally, I'll sit at the edge of a chair and stretch one direction behind my leg, and then the other hand, the other direction behind my leg. And I'll even do something more extreme, which is absolutely ridiculous. I've talked about this on the forums, where you grab your penis from behind your ass and pull it backwards. And it's amazing how much that helps me. So literally, pulling it right behind your ass like that, from behind your butt. It's amazing how much this has helped me. It's amazing. If I do it right now, if I could show you my deformity right now and then do the traction and I'm like change angles, you know, just both sides, move it to this side, move it to that side in quick succession, right? So I'm not holding that long. I'm just really changing the angle like that. The deformity, the difference in my deformity is massive. It's unbelievable. I showed a guy a photo of before and after and he's like, what the hell? Like, you know, yeah, that's insane. So there's a huge difference when I do this from just before and after. Now, Here's the thing. You got to wonder, like, is my case helped by this because the scarring's on the underside of my penis, or will everybody be helped by this downward kind of stuff, moving it back left and right, and really feeling it out, and focusing on the angle and the kind of stretch and the kind of ligaments in there. I don't know. I don't know if it's going to help everybody, and I'd love to know if it helps you or not. You got to be very, very careful. Obviously, you can cause Peyronie's with traction by hand. You can cause Peyronie's by traction, and you can cure Peyronie's by traction. You can cause Peyronie's with a vacuum device, and you can cure Peyronie's with a vacuum device. If you're getting Xiflex injections, the injection itself could cause more Peyronie's. There's always a risk, and it's totally on you to minimize that risk. And you know, we're kind of operating in no man's land. That's what I like to say with all this penile manipulation. It really is no man's land, and nobody's going to be able to help you if something bad happens. It's, you know, male sexuality is so ignored. It's so ignored. I mean, to be fair, you know, anything, even for women, you know, sexuality is, and the physiology of the vagina and the penis are very ignored. We just don't talk about, you know, how to deal with these kinds of things. But I really think that the downward stretching is key. And I may be wrong, but I think that the reason why it works so well to stretch down and behind your ass and all this is because I guess I can change this now, is because that's how you stretch the connective tissue. So right above your penis, you have a bunch of connective tissue, and you know, there's a name for all this, the penile ligament, and another like triangle shaped one, which is kind of like this big like sheath that goes over the top of your penis there. And then I don't know, but I think stretching out the connective tissue somehow helps the penis, kind of like when if you have Dupuytren's, which is the scarring of the pinky here. A lot of people with Peyronie's also have Dupuytren's. My father does, where it bends like this. They're advised to stretch it every single day. They have to. So it's the same thing. And with Dupuytren's, the connective tissue actually starts to scar over and get thicker here. So it's interesting. You know, we tend to think that Peyronie's is scarring that just comes out of the penis itself, like just appears. And that may be true. It may be true that you can just have scarring directly out of the penis, but keep in mind that the penis does have fascia, I'm not sure how to say that goes around it, connective tissue that goes around it. It's called Buck's fascia. And it could be that a lot of Peyronie's cases, or all of them, I don't know, is actually that fascia getting harder and scarring over. And you know, I mean, if you know that's not true and you're a urologist, and then that, and you know, that's fine, go ahead and say so. And you know, that's, I don't know that. I imagine you have cases of both. I've never seen the anatomy of a penis myself, so I don't know. But for me, stretching out the fascia and all of the connective tissue up here just really, really fixes my issue. It's incredible what it does for me. You know, I wish I knew about it earlier. I remember when I first started stretching down, it scared me. I thought like I'm gonna break something. And I think I actually think I heard like a pop one time, and it scared me so much that I just didn't do it again for like 6 months. This is when I first started out. I was just experimenting. And for me, my God, I lost my train of thought. So my erections have always been like straight up to my stomach ever since I was a kid. And whenever I had an erection, it would go up, never down. I could never push it down. I could never do doggy style. I remember trying to do doggy style, and then my penis would ache so bad, and I would see it bend, and it was just a nightmare. And I would have to squat down and do traction by hand and get rid of that deformity after sex. So part of what made me want to start stretching downward was I thought, okay, maybe there's something structurally off here. Maybe I do need to stretch the ligament and all that stuff, and maybe my penis should be able to go down, and I should be able to push my erection down. And sure enough, that helps for me. It helps me a lot. And again, I don't know if it's going to help you or not, and I know you could hurt yourself, so I don't want to recommend it to everybody. It really scares me. You know, if I start telling guys to get their erections to be able to bend down and stuff, you know, I don't want you to, first, I don't want you to manipulate your erect penis. That's a really bad idea. Interestingly, I actually can make my symptoms get a lot better by manipulating my erect penis, but you got to be careful with this. And I don't recommend it. I don't even do it myself, but when I'm erect, if I push from the very base of my penis, so I'm just very gently pushing down to stretch the connective tissue, afterwards my penis and my deformity is much better. But I'm also just too afraid to do that. I don't want to do that. You know, I've heard of guys trying to stretch that ligament by like putting a towel on their erect penis and like all this crap. And I don't recommend any of that stuff. I really think penile manipulation is really dangerous. You're in no man's land. If you're erect and you're manipulating your penis, you're in for a lot of trouble. You could easily damage yourself permanently. So keep that in mind. But also keep in mind that traction is an extremely powerful tool. The studies are all there. You know, it's all there for you to see. Go to the traction studies post on the Peyronie's forum, and I've compiled all the literature reviews and all the studies, and you can see like it's profound. So traction doesn't just work by stretching the scar tissue. Okay, it stretches your penile tissue. And it actually gets rid of some of those inflammatory things going on in there, like the TGF beta and some other stuff. It actually reduces some of these things that cause scarring. Isn't that interesting? So yeah, you can stretch the penis tissue and the scar tissue and remodel the penis over time. That's great. Second, for some reason, it's reducing this inflammation and certain stuff going on in the penis and making a better environment for your penis to be healthy. And third, this is a my personal theory, is that it gets rid of the hematomas or trapped blood in certain areas of your penis, and it allows oxygen-rich blood to flow through those damaged areas. So this is something I don't hear urologists talk about much, but I have read some things in literature about how blood and inflammation gets trapped between the layers of the tunica or parts of the part of the penis, because the penis is kind of like this mesh and certain areas get closed off. So after sex, you're all bent, right? Well, why is that? That's because when you have Peyronie's, or any kind of curve for that matter, your penis has less integrity. So when you're having sex, you're bending on it, and how can I show you this? And there's pressure on different areas of your penis, right? Different locations, especially where the scarring is or around there. So what's happening is that that part of your penis is becoming damaged, and the blood is getting trapped in there. And when you don't have fresh oxygen in or fresh blood in there, you're not getting oxygen. You're getting hypoxia, TGF beta, and eventually fibrosis. So you need to get blood moving through not only your penis but the damaged parts of your penis. This is why vacuum devices are so incredibly useful, right? And so I really think traction works based on these kind of three principles. And you really only think about number one, right? Where like, okay, you stretch the penis, therefore that must straighten it. Well, it's not really that simple. That's why, so this is really important. That's why gentle traction by hand. All I've done is a gentle traction by hand to different angles to get the blood moving through those different damaged parts of my penis. That's why traction is so effective, in my opinion, is to get the blood moving through those areas again so that area can start healing again. And even if you already have calcification, you want to make sure the blood is around there, right? You don't want more hypoxia and more damage to that area. So this is my, you know, personal theory, but it's also kind of backed up. You know, a lot of old studies I've read have talked about inflammation trapped in areas of the penis. I remember one of the first studies I ever read said that inflammation can be trapped in a man's penis for months before like turning into scarring, and that completely backs up my theory and makes perfect goddamn sense. So Don't think of traction as just a singular model thing where it's like, well, yeah, you just straighten it out. Think about traction and traction by hand, especially traction by hand, is this thing where you're just trying to kind of increase the health of your penis. And I really do it gently. I do not stretch my penis hard at all. Not at all. And maybe I should. Maybe if I did, it would be better. Maybe I would get better results. But so far, I really don't need to. I just need to be consistent, do it often, and focus on the angle. Literally, it's really embarrassing. That's part of the reason why I haven't made a video on this yet. But like every time I take a pee, like on the way up, I always sit when I pee, by the way. I used to, I mean, not always, right? But God, I remember it used to be hard to pee because of Peyronie's. It used to be really hard to pee because my penis would like buckle and bend when it was first happening. It was a nightmare. And now my penis just hangs straight because of traction. It hangs straight. I can pee straight down, and my erections look so much better. You can't even tell I have the disease, really, unless I really point it out and really try to make it apparent. Then I can do that. But yeah, every time I take a pee, I get up, and on the way up, I literally will bend my penis, or not bend, but stretch my penis under my leg or behind my ass. It's crazy, but it's what I have to do. It's what I gotta do. And nobody sees it, so fuck it. And after sex, sometimes I've said in another video, I will squat down and stretch my penis if I have to, or put like one leg on the bathtub and just like stretch my penis under my leg. And yeah, it sounds retarded, and I'm sure a lot of people would love to like. I think it's funny, it's definitely not funny. Peyronie's is not funny at all, but manual traction is seriously effective. Be careful, research traction, and consider what I'm saying about the three modalities, or whatever you'd want to call it, to that make traction work. Let me know too how downward traction by hand helps you in going from left to right. I really think it's amazing. It's amazing. I think it's the cure for Peyronie's, for me. And I'm very curious to see what you guys have to say about it. Maybe I'm wrong about it helping all men, and maybe you do have to stretch at an upward angle or something. I don't know. So let me know if you have questions about this. So I know a lot of you really want to know the details. I don't want to stop the video without answering all of your questions. I mean, I want to provide you with all the details you need, but I can't quite think of what else you might want to know. I can't tell you how long I stretch, but I do the sitting at the edge of the chair and downward to both sides under each leg. I also do leaning back and then straight out from my body while I'm watching a movie, and I'll go to different angles left and right. And I tend to change hands and change angles very quickly while watching a movie, or just doing whatever. And it's really dynamic and unpredictable. I can't give you a strict protocol. I'm sorry about that. So please feel free to ask me questions. I'd be happy to answer them. I guess I could also note that heat can have kind of a good effect with traction. So if it's really cold and my deformity has been really bad in the past, back when my diet was bad, but when I got insulin resistance back in the day, I was just 1 year ago when I had really bad insulin resistance. My deformity was terrible sometimes, and I would have to like put heat on it, put the rice sock on there, and then I would do traction. That can help a lot too. So heat can make traction easier. I think there's a synergistic effect. I think you could use the vacuum pump after traction as well, or you can mix all of these therapies. I mean, just imagine it. I mean, I wonder if there was a study on men who used the rice sock, or the heating, hyperthermia heat, plus the vacuum device, plus traction by hand, or traction with a device. I wonder if they did all of those every day. I wonder what the results would be compared to just one. You know what I mean? To one compared to one therapy. I think the three main physical therapies for Peyronie's that I mentioned in another video, I think they're very powerful. I think they're extremely powerful tools. And every day, I'm so thankful that traction by hand has helped me so much. I know some of you are afraid to do it, and I was very afraid to do it too. I was very scared to try it. But you kind of get comfortable with it, and eventually you know kind of, what your penis is capable of. The other thing is your penis probably gets adjusted to it over time. So don't just like pull so hard, I mean, be very gentle. Again, this is on you. You are kind of, as much as I can give you advice, you are alone in this. Your penis is your own. The damage you caused yourself is your own. And I can't, there's nothing I can say. I know I'm sticking on this point a little bit too long here, but it troubles me because I think this therapy is a miracle. And I also know it can cause more Peyronie's. So it's impossible for me to give you like what I can't really say what I want to say. But I appreciate you listening, and I really hope it works out for you. So I'm gonna go ahead and end the video, and go ahead and leave your comments, ask questions, and I'd be happy to try to answer everything I can. All right, good luck, and I'll talk to you soon.